Today, I'll show you how to transfer all the data from an old iPhone to a new iPhone. On the left is a new iPhone XR, and on the right is my current iPhone 7. But what I'm demonstrating in this video will work with any iPhone, but you'll need a Mac or PC with the latest iTunes software installed. First, plug the old iPhone into the computer using the USB plug. When iTunes loads up, there'll be a small phone icon that'll pop up, so just click on that. And on the next screen, it shows me information about my phone. And it's here where I'll be able to back up my phone by clicking up the Backup Now button. In this menu, if you choose to encrypt your backup, all your passwords should be saved when you restore your phone. But if you choose no encryption, you have to sign into all your apps that require usernames and passwords. But I decide I'm not going to encrypt my backup at this time. When I click on Don't Encrypt, iTunes will immediately start backing up your phone. The time it takes depends on how much data is on your phone, such as photos and apps. When it's done, eject the old phone and plug in the new iPhone. Here, tap on Trust Computer and enter the passcode if the phone has one. Because this iPhone has never been backed up on this computer, the new iPhone screen will show up. Here, there's an option to set the phone up to factory settings, or I can choose from a previous backup file. I definitely want to choose the latest backup, but here I ran into a problem which is probably good to show you. So when I click on Continue, an error comes up that says it can't restore the backup file to my new phone. The reason is that the two phones I have are on different versions of iOS. The old iPhone 7 is running 12.2 and my new iPhone XR is on 12.1. So now I have to choose to set up my XR as a new iPhone first. Click Continue and iTunes will show the information page for the XR. I'm going to click on Update to get my iPhone XR into iOS 12.2. Now agree to all the legal stuff and then enter the passcode on the phone if it has one. Updating the iOS could take a while because it needs to download the file onto the computer first before installing, but this should be all one step. When the update is done, I can confirm that my iPhone XR is now on iOS 12.2 and ready for restoring. Click on Restore Backup and choose the latest backup file. Now click on the Restore button. Again, this process could take a while depending on how big the backup file is. I'm speeding up this video for demonstration purposes, but my iPhone took about 10 minutes to restore. During this process, the screen will show Restore in Progress. When the restoration process is done, just follow the instructions on the phone. There'll be some more processing that needs to be done before it's complete. Again, this will take some time, but when the backup has been fully restored to the iPhone, there'll be a confirmation on the screen. At this point, the phone is going to have to finish downloading all the apps that were installed on the old phone. In addition to reinstalling apps, the iPhone will restore all the photos from the backup. The thumbnails will just take a bit of time to repopulate. So here we just have to be patient until it's finished. And when it's done, my new iPhone XR will have all the files from my old iPhone 7 on it. And remember when I chose not to encrypt my backup? Well, it turns out that some of the apps retain my login information, but not all of them. And after the restoration, I can start using my new iPhone XR with all of my stuff on it. And before I end this video, I just want to reiterate that this backup and restoration process can be done on any iPhone on a Mac or PC with iTunes installed. If this video was helpful, please give me a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button to stay up to date on all my tech tutorials. Thanks for watching.